What's good? Yeah, guess I have to figure out an introduction sometime soon, but today we have to talk about the Atomos Ninja and its pricey SSD solutions. So let's get into it. There are two options you can choose. Either you opt in for a compatible but bulky 2.5 inch SSD, which you can fit into the SSD caddy. Actually, that's provided by Atomos themselves in the package you get with the Ninja 5. Or you opt in for the expensive AtomX SSDmini, which sets you back around 475 euros right now. This is insane. Not gonna lie. So finally, after some research I did, there was a solution, which is 3D printed caddies, which are not as bulky and should provide better airflow, obviously, but they are not really convincing nor a smart option, at least to me. Then I found out about Angelbird's AtomX CF Adapter, which makes perfect sense when you already own a camera that supports CFast cards, unlike my Canon R6, but you can use them right away. And I think that's a pretty good solution if you already acquired some of these cards and it would cost you around 95 euros. So I had to continue my search. About 4 cups of coffee later. Yeah, and I do think that slurped coffee is actually a timer unit. I stumbled upon an interesting piece, which was dubbed the LunchBox by Andycine. And guess what? I never heard of them before. So this is a well-thought construction out of a magnesium aluminium. And it really seemed legit, especially since the price tag was sitting at around 30 euros, which wasn't particularly attractive. Now, the great thing of this little adapter and caddy is that you can fit any mSATA drive into it. They advise you to stick with the Samsung T5 that cost me around 120 euros, which is compatible with the Ninja, but some people suggest sticking with other Samsung drives. Actually, I will link them below in the description. They should work fine too. However, choose whatever is available. Well, I should have watched some videos before trying to disassemble the T5, since this took me literally ages. There are dozens of videos that show how to disassemble the T5, but there's one video that's actually really helpful. So props to the channel of HackTip, who has a brilliant video of how to remove the mSATA from the Samsung T5 drive. The video is linked down in the description. So here we have the time-lapse of the entire disassembling process, as well as the conversion from the mSATA to SATA. There are only 5 turrets we need to get the job done. First, we need a Phillips screwdriver, size 00, a fruit knife, scissor, tweezer, and lastly, a USB-C cable. So on the side with the USB-C connector, there's actually a sticker just placed on top of it with a really strong adhesive. So take your fruit knife, fiddle it under one side of the sticker, try to lift it up gently, and just peel the sticker off either with your hands or the tweezer. All right. Now you uncover 2 screws that you can just pull out with this screwdriver. You will realize that Samsung's casing really fits like a glove. It's so snug you cannot simply pull out the tray inside of this casing. So you're gonna use the USB-C cable, plug it in, and then just pull it out and it will slide out with ease. Now you have freed the tray with the entire mainboard on it. First step is removing the thermal pad. You can do it with some tweezers or by your hands, whatever is best suitable for you. Next, loosen all 3 screws on the mainboard. There are 2 located on the mSATA and 1 on the adapter itself. So to remove the mainboard from the tray, you will find that there are 2 pins on either side of it securing the mainboard. You can either try pushing one side down and lifting up the mainboard. But what I just learned is push the USB-C port pretty hard and it will slid out the backside. Now, make sure to turn the mainboard upside down and remove this 2nd thermal pad. After you've done that, you can simply slide the mSATA out of the adapter connector. What we're going to do now is converting the mSATA to regular SATA. It has been USB-C to mSATA before, so let's get this done. Andycine provides you with a total of 4 components. You will may find yourself confused by the components provided in Andycine's package. However, I will explain. So essentially what the server housing is, it's half the enclosure for a future mSATA to SATA drive. So before touching the housing or installing anything onto it, we have to marry the mSATA with the provided adapter by Andycine. This process is as easy as removing the mSATA from the previous adapter. You just slide it into it. There's a specific locking mechanism that secures the mSATA in the adapter. So you have to press down the mSATA and tighten those screws. There are two in total. Once done, put a thermal pad provided by Andycine onto it. You may find yourself in a situation that you have to adjust it. So just align it and trim it with some scissor. Whenever you apply a thermal pad, just remove one side of the adhesive, which is shielded by a plastic layer. If it fits well, remove the other side of the adhesive. So once again, turn the mainboard upside down and place it into the housing. It should just fit snug. It really is designed beautifully. It just fits perfectly. We are almost there. Now we have to apply another thermal pad. And let me tell you that the pads by Andycine will be way too large for this one. So you need to trim it down again. My suggestion is leave half an inch of space on each side of the mainboard. Witness my OCD in all its glory when I try to align the thermal pad roughly 7 times. The second last step is making sure that the cover plate aligns with all the drilled holes for the M3 screws. So align it perfectly, because otherwise you will probably mess up the thermal pad. Put the M3 screws into the markings and tighten them with the Allen wrench provided by Andycine as well. And there you go. Your own mSATA to SATA drive is now assembled and you can use it right away with your Atomos Ninja 5. So the second best thing, except for the savings, is that your own SSD measures 24 millimeters shorter in length than the AtomX SSD Mini, and it looks so much better. So if you got any question regarding the Lunchbox, feel free to ask me in the comments or send me a direct message, whatever. Und ich antworte auch auf Deutsch, also haut rein.